crowd here. Let's hope this continues, and because these kids need it. We're doing some good things here at Rochester High School, and come and support these kids. There's no doubt about them needing it. That makes a difference in games when the crowd gets going.
So it'll be Medina and Hansel to jump center. Ball is up, and the tip controlled by the Culver Cavaliers. Graham will run the point against Rochester's man-to-man defense against Brett Abbott. Backs it out to the center circle. Now to the elbow to Kresik. Quickly to Hansel. To Kruger. Kruger tries to feed down low to the post. Kresik has it against Medina. Backs him way down low into the paint. Throws up a shot on the glass. It goes.
Nice post move. Number 33. Thought Medina might pick up a foul, but he did a good job to keep his body back.
Zebras quickly up the floor. Culver will start defensively in a 2-3 zone as Alec Holland runs the point. Now swings left side of Medina. Stands behind the arc about a foot or two. To Holland, swings right side of Abbott. Brett in the corner to Dahlquist. Back to Abbott, near side to Holland. Alec, pass quickly to Medina. On the baseline to Dom Thomas. Has his pass tipped away and stolen by Culver. And then they can't save from going out of bounds and go back to Rochester.
Give the kid credit. Nice play on there. The ball went out of bounds, but he did the right thing is to put it towards your own basket. Save it. A lot of kids like to save it straight back, which would have been to Rochester's basket, but at least he tried to fling it towards his own basket.
You know, you hear that a lot in stuff to teach unless you work on it over and over.
Yeah, you got to really be thinking about those plays ahead of time versus just reacting to them.
A minute gone in the first quarter. Culver up 2-0. Zebras basketball going to our left. Rochester in their home white. Black numbers, black letters. And now we're going to have a legal screen on Don Thomas, I believe, and that's going to give it back to Culver. First turnover of the game goes to the Rochester Zebras.
And also second defensive possession, second different defense for Culver. They showed on 2-3 that possession. They switched into man. See if they continue switching defenses as the Zebras come out a little pressure. I know Coach Reinhold's been working on this most of the preseason.
Hansel, again to Graham, works against Abbott. Graham clears out, crosses the timeline, makes that to Kruger, and then Kruger is going to be called for over and back. Nice defense by Brett Abbott, not giving him any space to tiptoe to the center line, and falls into his Rochester side.
Yeah, for those of you familiar with college basketball, I know Coach Reinhold's really been studying that VCU type of system where it's kind of a hybrid, looks like a man, looks like a zone, and just trying to use that to kind of change momentum during games.
Dom on the block outside of Dahlquist, now to Holland. He'll fire a three. Right wing, no good, and the rebound to Kresik, and he'll go off to Kruger. Kruger runs down the right side of the floor, right in front of the Rochester bench, loses the handle, picks up the basketball with Holland in his grill. Now on the baseline to Villaquette. No, Dom Thomas knocked it off of Villaquette out of bounds, but the official's going to say that it's going to stay with Culver.
Yeah, right. It looked like Dom did have it knocked off his knee. That was good pressure. Everybody's kind of extended even out beyond three-point line. Dahlquist is out there. Dom's out there. It's good to see these guys active and getting into it early defensively.
I like to have 6-4 at the top of that three-point line. And now we're going to have an illegal screen down low, or is it going to be a foul on Dahlquist down low?
He's going to call a double foul. Take the easy way out.
You're banging already with a minute and a half to go on in the game, and we got a double foul.
Early on, I don't know. Usually you go advantage-disadvantage. I don't know that necessarily affected the play, but.
So Culver will keep it baseline right. Graham looks to get it in, does so to Hansel. Hansel to baseline against Medina. Feeds down a little Villaquette on the blocks, outside to Hansel. Right wing to Kruger. Kruger against Holland over the top of the defense, down a little Villaquette. His shot of the window is good.
It's a well-executed lob play. Perfect pass.
Not a lot of room to work it either. Dom Thomas, 15-footer right baseline. No good. Ball being tipped around. Hansel comes out of there with it. Out of Villaquette. Out of Kruger right side. Behind the arc. Works against the defense, the man-to-man defense. And the entry pass is knocked away by Dom. Dahlquist and out of bounds. It'll stay with Culver baseline right.
Small play, but a big thing. If you can throw a bounce pass in the post like that, it makes the post player's job a lot easier.
Lob pass comes in to Hansel at the free throw line. Ball loose again, picked up by Culver High on the left side. Graham with the basketball. Now we'll bring it up top and reset against Brett Abbott. Drives it right, hesitates, switches directions. Now goes left. Now to Hansel against Medina in the corner to Kruger. Kruger down low to Graham. Pass is knocked away out of bounds by Abbott. Culver going to keep it again out of bounds with 5:37 to play. The first quarter, the Cavs lead 4-0. Graham looks to trigger in baseline left. And his pass is deflected out of bounds by Abbott, and we'll try it again.
Good deflection. Zebras staying mostly in their man-to-man, but really got to talk on the screens. Culver setting a lot of screening action. Zebras going to have to get through and fight through those best they can.
Again, a bounce pass would have probably got to them pretty safely. Graham looks to get it in around Abbott. Still looking to get it in over the top of the defense. The handful to the volleyball line. And then fakes the handoff and drives it left. The three-point line outside to Graham. Graham against Abbott. And Abbott just about picks his pocket. Graham picks it up. Sees down a little bit of sweat. His layup off the glass is good. When we have a moment, tell me about the hand-checking rules.
Okay.
Abbott in the paint. Stop. Rises up. Shot short. And Hansel the rebound for the Cavaliers. 6-0 Cavs. And Culver runs. Threads a needle, and the pass goes out of bounds. Intended for Villacueta. It's going to go back to Rochester.
You want to do it now?
Absolutely.
Okay. Just took the IHSA rules meeting this year. The point of emphasis is anytime you put two hands on the dribbler, they said in that video that's supposed to be a foul every time. Or if you put a hand on multiple times in that dribbling possession, should be a foul.
Dahlquist misses the rim, and then Dom Thomas comes flying in and grabs the rebound and puts it in for two, and Rochester now down by four, 6-2.
And that's also supposed to count as an armbar in the post. You also are not supposed to use an armbar to defend in the post either.
So it's one hand and not two.
Two hands on there at any time, that should be a foul. Or if it's one hand multiple times within the possession, that jab, push, 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 both of those should be fouled. Or the armbar when you're defending the post where you have your whole forearm on the post player's back as he's trying to post you up.
No, Dahlquist just picked up foul number two, and in comes Jordan Reinholdt. Jordan is a 6-foot freshman for the Zebras. And Culver has it, baseline left. Kruger, wide open three from the left wing. Off the mark, no good, but an offensive rebound to Kresnik. He puts it up over Jordan. Reinholdt, it's no good, but a foul coming on Reinholdt. That's going to send Kresnik to the line to shoot two.
Kresnik's very active inside. Zebras haven't quite found an answer. He's good post moves. They're looking for him. He's very active. You don't want to start giving up offensive rebounds, especially when you're playing man-to-man.
Well, like you always say, offensive rebound either going to be 2 points or a foul. And they proved you right once again. The free throw by Kresnik is good.
Especially in high school basketball.
Yeah.
The boys, girls, you know, you usually see it. You give up an offensive rebound, either you're going to foul or they're going to score.
Kresnik has one more. Josh, second one on the way, no good, in and out. And the rebound fall four is going to go out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Rochester. And Culver will keep possession, baseline left with 4:36 to play in the first quarter, leading 7-2. Graham will try to inbound around to Brett Abbott. Graham studies, lobs it into Kresnik in the left corner. Kresnik still holds against Medina, takes him high on the left side, now to the circle, and now hands off to Graham. Graham around the defense, now on the left elbow, throws up a teardrop shot off the glass, no good. Rebound to Thomas, to outlet to Abbott. Abbott will go in for the left-handed layup, and it is good.
Great outlet look by Dom Thomas. That's another lost start.
7-4. Full court press by the Zebras. Kresnik against Medina, really bodies him up, and Medina finally picks up a foul, which probably could have been the third one here in this quarter. 4:08 to play in the first quarter. Rochester's cut the Culver lead to 3. Taylor Medina has picked up foul number one.
Just off of the Zebras.
Yeah,
you also don't want to start sending them to the free throw line this early.
Carnegie will look to get it in around Jordan Reinholdt. Just to the Graham, right underneath the Rochester basket. Graham is picked up at the Rochester free throw line. Three-quarter quarter by Brett Abbott. Crosses the timeline. Here comes a double team. Gets across court to Kruger. Kruger back to Graham, top of the key. Graham drives it right. No look pass in the corner to Villacuet. One dribble. Gets it back to Graham. Graham in the lane. Outside to Villacuet. Looks at a 15-footer. Passes it up. Back to Graham, top of the key. Culver with the basketball going to our right. Graham backs it out and resets for Cavs. Now to Kresnik. To Kruger. Behind the arc left side against Holland. Man-to-man defense by the Zebras. The jump pass out to Graham, and he travels going to the basket.
I have that as being unofficially the third turnover for Culver. I guess all my statistics are unofficial, but
no way. No, Dahlquist back into the game. Thomas comes out with 3:34 to play in the first quarter. The Cavs by 3. And Justin Schultz, he's a load. A wide-body 6'3 kid, sophomore, comes into the game for junior, that is, for the Cavaliers. 7-4 Culver, Rochester the basketball. Reinholdt, left side, drives it to the free throw line. Outside to Abbott, behind the arc in the corner to Holland. He'll fire another three from the baseline, too hard. And Medina grabs the offensive board. Back out to Holland, he'll try it again from the corner. It's good, and we're tied at 7. Full-court press by the Zebras. Carnegie quickly up the floor for the Cavs. Crossover dribble takes him to the middle. Now outside to Kruger at the volleyball line, high on the right side. Drives against Reinhold takes him to the baseline. The jump pass outside to Carnegie. Now to Graham. Fakes a three. Down low to Kresik. His shot blocked by Dahlquist. Now gives to Reinhold. Left side of the floor. No look pass to Medina. Spot up three from the left wing. It's good!
Two.
Rochester up 9-7. The first lead of the year. Carnegie breaks the press. Left side of the floor. Travels. Thomas will come back into the game.
See the impact of that. The offense leads to defense. He knocks some shots down. Coach can set up the pressure. Guys getting into it, being really active. You get the other team out of a rhythm and making a little run here.
Here's
good.
Here's what I see early on in this season. I didn't see a lot early last year. Is our guys looking for their shot?
Looking for shot and moving the ball.
I mean,
Medina makes that Holland three possible by hitting the boards hard and kicking it right back to him and give him another look.
Medina's shot no good. Fight for the rebound. It's going to go out of bounds on last touch by Culver, but I believe Reinhold's going to pick up another foul.
Yep, it's going to be two on the young freshman and Zebra six, so Culver will be shooting free throws the rest of the half. That's the one thing about the pressure defense sometimes, too, though. It could lead to some foul situations, especially early on in the year as you're working through a new defensive system. Zebra's going to match up and go a little man-to-man press here.
Liam Leininger, the 5'11 freshman, replaces Reinhold with two personal fouls. And Graham has his pass picked off by Leininger, and Liam will bring it across the timeline right through the center circle. Now left side to Abbott. Abbott on the baseline. Got away from the travel. Outside to Medina. No look to Holland. He'll take a three from the baseline. In and out. No good. Rebound to Kruger and the Cavaliers. 9-7 Rochester. Under two to play in the first quarter. Kruger through the defense. Loses the handle. Out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Culver. It'll go back to Rochester.
Fifth turnovers on the Cavs. Zebras have only committed one to this point.
But six fouls.
Right. Yep.
Yeah. A minute 50 to play. First quarter, Rochester up 9-7. Abbott holds high on the left side. Zone defense by the Cavaliers. Out to Holland. Three right wing. In and out, no good. And the rebound to Abbott. His put back on the way is no good, but a foul coming on Culver. And that's going to send Abbott to the line to shoot two.
Zebras getting some good looks, not going down. But the other thing I really like about that is they're not, as those shots are going up, they're working really hard on the board. The Abbott gets that put back. And once again, we have a foul on Culver. Abbott's going to go line to shoot two.
Tristan Schultz, the 6'3 junior, picks up a foul. Villaquette and also Hansel will come back into the next opportunity for Cavaliers, which is right now after the miss by Abbott. Into the game for the first time, Wilson Lee for Rochester. Wilson Lee is a 5'10 junior. He replaces Leininger for the Zebras. 100 seconds to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 9-7. And Abbott with one more for the Z's. Eyes the second one, good. Rochester up by three.
Number 20, Preston Hansel.
Hansel with the inbound pass. Couple of dribbles, back to Graham. Fakes the pass, now drives it to the volleyball line across the timeline. Picked up by the double against the double team. Quickly to Kruger. 18-footer left baseline, no good. Good block out by Wilson Lee. He grabs the board. Outlet to Holland. Spots up for three, right wing is short. And the rebound to the Cavaliers and Kresik. Quickly to Graham. Graham gives to Hansel. Jump pass outside to Graham. Top of the key. Three straight away is on the way. It's in and out. No good. Offensive rebound to Villaquette. His put back over Thomas is no good. The put back by Hansel's good. 10-9 Rochester. A minute to play in the first quarter.
Culver showing to be equally aggressive on the offensive boards. That's one thing early on. It's just the timing of those small things of taking care of your blockouts lead to some second chance points.
Holland again. Straight away. Three is good again. Good looking shot by Alec Holland, and he's got the 6 of the 13. It's 13-9 Rochester, 40 seconds to play, first quarter. Hansel dribbles to the elbow extended right, now backs it outside. Still with a dribble, now picks the basketball up, got to get rid of it. Does the Villaquette, back to Hansel. Down low, ball stripped away, last touch by Culver, off the feet of Hansel, out of bounds. Rochester going to get it back.
Sixth turnover of the half, see if the Zebras can't hold for a final shot here with just under 30 seconds.
So Dominic Thomas comes out of the game, and back into the game is Noah Dahlquist with 28 seconds to play, first quarter. Rochester up by four and will probably look for the final shot of the period. Abbott runs the point against Hansel through the center circle, works it right. Now to Wilson Lee, top of the key, left side to Medina. Baseline to Holland. Holland, quick three for the late Zebras is no good, but a foul coming on the shot. That's going to send Holland to the line to shoot three.
Yep, you got to let the shooter land. As I've been saying this year.
I was just going to say that. Yeah. I've heard you mention that several times to the officials. I don't think that they're hearing you. Obviously, that they're doing the right thing in the guys' game.
Yeah, I mean, that's a textbook simple example there. When the shooter goes up, the shot continues till they land, and you have to let the shooter land before you start the block out.
First free throw is good.
Especially, you know, from that distance into the girls' game, that's how you hurt some knees and some ankles by, you know, blocking them up.
Yeah.
Ground. So the safety issue as much as anything else.
Two more for Holland. Second one on the way is good again. Leininger and Thomas in. Dahlquist. Well, Leininger will come in for Alec Holland if he hits this free throw. Weston Bush, a 5'8 junior, in the game for the first time for the Cavs. Third one by Holland is good again. So Holland is out, Leininger is in. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. 15 seconds to play, first quarter, Rochester by 7. 16-9.
Holland has 9 himself in the first quarter.
Bush has his pass stolen by Abbott. Abbott middle of the floor with 8. Now works to the right wing with 6. Dribbles back to the middle of the floor with 4. Abbott then carries the basketball. Going to give it back to Culver. Unforced turnover, 3.5 seconds to play, first quarter.
Yeah, not necessarily not a true point guard look here for the Zebras, and he kind of got lost in carrying it.
3.5 seconds. Kruger with 2. Kruger across the timeline, loses the handle, throws up a half quarter at the buzzer, no good. After 1, Rochester leads 16-9. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
16, Culver 9. Good looking shot by the Zebras in that first period.
Yeah, movement's good. They're getting some offensive rebounds. I think coach has got to be happy with their getting into the pressure, because pressure is so important, because you got to make some shots to get into it. But then secondly, you got to have all 5 guys working really hard. If 4 guys are in their spots in a pressure defense and somebody's slow or somebody's not really into it, that's when you give up layups. And Culver's gotten a couple good looks, but you know, the tempo has definitely seemed to be more comfortable for the Zebras than it is for Culver at this point.
Well, as nice it is to see Rochester getting some offensive boards, unfortunately they gave some up in the first quarter.
Yeah, and that'll be a big stat to go through along with the fouls, because you know Culver's going to shoot free throws the rest of the half.
Thomas to Medina, high on the right side. Rochester starts the second quarter of the basketball. Culver now in a man-to-man defense. Thomas behind the arc, gives to Holland, who's back in the basketball game and drives it. Throws up a shot off the glass, no good. Rebound to Wilson Lee, kicks it out to Leininger. Right side to Holland, 3, right baseline, no good. Rebound fall forward, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Medina, it's going to go back to Culver.
Good signs, though, you know, they're still crashing the boards. That can create some extra opportunities. Wilson Lee's crashed the boards. Medina almost had one there, but, you know, you're knocking some good shots. Keep hitting the boards, keep trying to create some offense that way.
30 seconds have gone in the second quarter. Rochester up 16-9. I like Alec Holland not stopping right now. You know, some kids that not with as much confidence will say, well, you know what, I've missed 3 or 4 now. I'm done. I'm not going to keep shooting.
Yeah, and he's got to hit that shot. You know, he's your kind of leading returning scorer. You know, sometimes you have to let him kind of shoot their way in it. I mean, taking within the rhythm of the offense. You know, get that thing dialed in here a little bit, and then that'll help everybody else out as well.
Bush to Kruger, 3, no good. And the rebound to Thomas. Good block out by Dom. Now outlet pass to Abbott. Rochester runs to our left. Abbott middle of the floor. Right side pass to Medina. Medina pull up 17-footer on the way. It's good. Good looking shot for the senior. And now Rochester up by 9.
He can hit that shot consistently. This offense goes to a whole different place.
Yep. Full court press. Jump pass ahead to Bush. Got away with a double dribble. And now he travels. Another turnover on the Cavaliers. And Holland back into the game. Also into the game for the first time. is Tristan Foster, a 6'1 junior who's been fighting pneumonia, I think, that Coach Ryan Holt told me just a little bit ago.
Both coaches showing a liberal use of the bench and just not maybe not a large number of players, but keeping guys in and out,
yeah.
Keeping them fresh. You see that early on, but I think both teams with the pace of the game, you got to keep those fresh legs in.
Back in for Culver's Carnegie. 18-9 Rochester, 6:40 to play in the first half. Rochester basketball going to our left. Foster to Medina, just inside the arc, top of the key, now to Abbott. Abbott drives it left in the paint, stops, kicks it outside to Leininger, now to Foster. He'll throw the shot up from the free throw line, no good. Ball loose, Culver picks it up, Kruger runs. Kruger, middle of the floor, picks his way through traffic, goes to the basket, layup on the way is good. 18-11, Rochester lead is 7. 6:14 to play in the first half. Leininger to Holland, down near side to Abbott. Stands in the corner. Abbott a couple of dribbles right in front of the Culver bench. Works to the middle of the floor. Now goes to the basket. Shot on the way, the fall away, no good. Rebound to Hansel and Culver. Outlet pass to Carnegie, and then has this pass knocked away by Holland.
Nice play, good athleticism. Smart play, just getting deflected. Nice outlet attempt.
Yeah.
But Culver also switching up their defense, play more man-to-man. Both teams showing up, changing defenses a little bit, and the other team's got to have to adjust.
Thomas back into the game, and Foster to sit. 5:54 to play first half, Rochester by 7. And in the corner will be Culver basketball. Graham looks to get it in. Bounce pass right in front of Coach Reinholt to Kresik. Now to Kruger, stands with the ball above his head. High on the right side against Abbott. Kruger. Jump pass down low to Hansel. Wrap around pass to Carnegie. Shot good and a foul.
A nice play recognizing the overhelp and just making that extra pass. Would have been a good shot, but the young man makes the pass across the lane to the opposite post. That's just a really nice play.
So Hansel just tapped his belly. He's coming out. They give him the trash can. I got a feeling that he's not feeling well. I don't want to hear that nor see that.
Very observant.
Carnegie's free throw, no good. Thomas with the rebound. Outlet to Holland. Rochester runs. Up by 5. Holland hesitates. Accelerates. Pulls it back outside to Medina. And now to Thomas. Thomas top of the key, near side of Leininger. Leininger between the rings. Works it right side. Behind his back dribble. Works against Carnegie in the man-to-man defense. High on the left side to Abbott. Abbott a couple of dribbles for Rochester. Middle of the floor, switches direction, goes left. Cut off by the defense. Back door to Holland. Layup is good.
Two juniors have played a lot of basketball together on that play.
20-13. Rochester back by 7. Kresik to Kruger. Kruger goes to the rack. Shot before the shot. He's going to be fouled as he throws up a circus-type shot after the foul. And it's going to be weighed off as it goes in.
Medina's second. Team's eighth.
Speaking of continuation, was that last night that you guys were fouled at the free throw line, did not shoot until a midway through the lane, and they counted it?
That was LaVille.
That was LaVille?
No, McConaughey. McConaughey, you're right.
Hey, good grief.
Yeah.
So it was this week. Free throw by Kruger is good.
Hey, with the schedule we just kind of finished, I get you. They all kind of blended together.
Second one by Kruger is good again. 20-15, Rochester by 5 with 5 to play in the first half. Abbott runs the point for Rochester against Kruger in the man-to-man defense. Bounce pass to Holland on the right side. Now back to Kruger, makes that to Abbott, top of the key. Passes to Medina, stands behind the three-point line. Now to Holland on the baseline. Back to Abbott, high on the right side for the Zebras. Rochester up 20-15. Medina fakes the shot, drives it, goes up. Shot good and a foul.
Like the Zebras putting the ball on the floor more this year, trying to create, trying to attack the basket, not just relying on passing on the perimeter, but getting in that attack mode now as they're playing man-to-man.
Medina at the line for the first time tonight. Rochester up 22-15. It's 4:40 to play in the first half. Medina's free throw no good, and Carnegie with a rebound clears it. Kruger. Kresik walks it up the floor, crosses the timeline, down the corner to Villaquet. Back to Kresik. Down low, shot over Medina is good. Boy, I like his kid. Josh Kresik, a 6'1 sophomore, wide body.
Fifth point, but every time they've gotten the ball to him inside, he's finished.
Thomas on the left baseline. Man-to-man defense. Down to Medina on the left wing. Top to Holland. Three on the way over the defense. Is no good. Kruger skies the board. Rips it down one-handed. Now leads ahead to Villaquette. Right-handed layup on the way is good.
Good fundamental move with the shot fake, too. Good outlet pass. I mean, that's a really good basketball play. Poor transition defense, but a good offense.
Right.
Play.
We've seen a lot of long outlet passes.
And that's one of the things, too. You know, as both teams, I think, are especially as Zebras, that's a fine line. You want guys battling for offensive boards, but you got to make sure you keep at least somebody back.
Yeah.
You like the intensity of trying to get to the boards, but somebody's got to stay back to prevent the easy layups.
Rochester commits another turnover on the travel. Under four to play in the first half. Rochester up 22-19. And the pass is knocked away, but right back in the hands of Kruger. Spins away from the defense. Goes to the baseline. Cut off by Dahlquist. Now gets a triple team. Loses the handle. And then Brett Abbott picks up the ball. And then we're going to have a foul coming against Kruger. It'll be Rochester basketball on the end line. Needs to go the length of the court to our left. 3:43 to play in the first half. Rochester up 22-19. It'll be Zebra basketball as Holland will walk it up, and he'll be picked up by Graham at the volleyball line. High on the right side to Reinholdt. Stands the ball above his head. Jordan bounce pass to Medina, top of the key. Swings the left side at Abbott. Down low to Reinholdt on the block. Now back to back outside to Abbott behind the arc in the left wing. Brett, a couple of dribbles. Works to the middle of the floor. Picks up the dribble, now to Medina. Medina holds. Passes to Reinholdt between the circles. Right side to Abbott with 3:15 to play in the first half. Rochester up 22-19. We're going to have a moving screen on Dahlquist. And that'll be number three on Noah Dahlquist.
Yep, it's a good play. He's going for the ball screen, but you got to get set and let the dribbler run the defender into you and not try to lean into the defender.
Dahlquist more than likely done for the half as Dom Thomas back in for the Zebras. A 3:13 to play in the first half. Rochester up 22-19.
Zebras in a little 2-2-1 three-quarters court trap here. Looks familiar.
Carnegie wraparound pass to Graham. Gives him the corner. Back outside to Graham in the paint. Fakes the pass. Goes up to Villaquest, and he shoots it over Reinholdt and cuts the Rochester lead to one. Medina hard to the basket, throws up a shot. Kruger going to pick up a foul. That's going to send Taylor Medina to the line to shoot two.
That foul's on Kruger. That's a big foul. That's his second. Yep, that's his second. So your leading returning scorer there has picked up his second. Team six. Zebras will also shoot the rest of the half, including Medina's two shots here. He's got 6 points on the night. Second to Alec Holland's 11 for the Zebras.
Taylor Medina eyes the first one, flies it. It's no good. He'll have one more. Hansel back in, and Kruger to come out. Also, Wilson Lee back in for Rochester, and Jordan Reinholdt to come out.
Zebras so far 4-for-7, but Holland is 3-for-3, so Medina's 0-for-2. Got to take advantage of these points when you're getting to the line.
Medina will have one more, looking to push this lead back to two. Second for the seniors, good this time. 23-21, Rochester on top with 2:50 to play in the first half.
Back into the 2-2-1.
Hansel with the basketball. Ahead to Carnegie. Carnegie almost has his pocket picked. Gets it to Hansel. And then his pass is stolen by Dom Thomas. And then his pass is going to be knocked away and stolen by Carnegie. And Carnegie travels. Rochester will keep possession with 2.5 to play in the first half. 23-21 Rochester.
A little chaotic this first two games kind of get.
JV game went to Rochester over Culver tonight, 46-36. Brett Abbott gets the inbounds pass from Medina. We'll walk it through the center circle. Hansel will guard him on a man-to-man defense. Top to Wilson Lee, left side to Medina. Medina holds with the basketball behind the arc in the wing. Back to Lee, high on the right side to Abbott. Abbott will pull it out and reset again with 2:15 to play in the first half. Rochester up by two. Abbott to the wing. Got it, Lee. Switches to Medina, bounce pass to Holland on the left baseline. Dumps down low to Thomas. This turnaround jumper on the block is too hard. No good. Carnegie with the rebound. Got a handful of good hands off to Graham. Rochester in a man-to-man defense. Graham's across the timeline to Carnegie on the right baseline. Carnegie against Thomas. Loses the handle. Now picks up the basketball. Down low to Villaquette. Wrap around pass to Hansel. His jumper in the lane is good.
You know, the Culver's doing... They're just attacking the middle of the defense. Zebras a little slow to rotate here as we get to the end of the half, and they're giving up layups inside.
Legs, you suppose?
Yeah, a little bit.
And Dom Thomas commits a turnover. He travels. It'll go back to the Cavaliers.
Still got to just learn the rotation.
That's going to be a foul.
Ooh.
It's going to be a foul on Dom.
Huh.
Still the same turnover, but a foul. I don't know what if you backed in too hard or you're rapping with the elbow. I couldn't see that from here. I was blocked. Five turnovers to the Zebras, nine for Culver. Good for Culver, had six after one.
Yep.
And the trap just about forced a turnover. Villaquette then traveled. Minute 27 to play, first half. We're tied at 23. Foster back into the game, and Wilson Lee to sit. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Tied at 23 here late in the first half at Rochester High School.
Seemed like Zebras were in control here about 5 minutes ago, and now you look up at the score, it seems like they've been playing well, but now they're back in a tie game situation.
And we haven't seen one of those 15-plus jump shots yet. Foster drives, shot, no good. Rebound by Culver. Now to Hansel. Gives to Graham. Graham's got to get back to Hansel with a minute five, and then Culver will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. A minute five to play in the first half. We're tied at 23, Tony.
Thanks for Val from Sentinel for these scores. Boys action tonight. Traditional opening game. Lewis Cass 20, North Miami 4 at the end of the first quarter. And the battle of heavyweight teams here, I think. Logansport leads Peru at the end of the first quarter 22-11.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's surprising.
Yeah. Wonder where that game's at.
I think Jim's got the horses to go away this year.
I think so. I wonder if they're all, provided they're all healthy and eligible, he's got, he does have a team. And Logansport, obviously, is stacked,
yeah.
No doubt as well.
Yeah. Culver basketball after their timeout. Carnegie gets the pass in to Schultz, ahead to Villaquette. Layup is good. Culver is up 25-23. Quickly, Rochester up the court. Under a minute to play, first half. Holland drives, layup is good, and we're tied at 25.
13 for Holland.
Good for him. 45 seconds to play, first half. Bounce pass into Carnegie. Carnegie then is fouled by Foster, and that's going to send him to the line to shoot two.
That's a situation where just a young kid making a mistake. You had him where you want him. You had him on the sideline. You had him contained. You had help maybe coming over a little bit. You know, that far, 80 feet from the basket when your team's already shooting free throws at the end of the half, that's not the play you want.
So Nate Carnegie, a 6'3 sophomore at the line, to shoot two for the Cavaliers. We're tied at 45, 43 seconds to play.
45.
We are tied at 25.
Yeah.
With 43 seconds to play in the first half. First free throw is missed. Reinhold back in. Foster down.
You start saying we're tied at 45 with 43 seconds to go in the first half. That'd be
first game of the year.
Yeah.
That's a pretty good clip. Carnegie's second one. Good this time. Culver up 26-25. 40 seconds to play, first half. Holland quickly up the floor, right side of the floor for the Zebras. Now to Medina, quickly left side to Abbott. And the bounce pass is at Reinhold's feet. Goes out of bounds, it'll go back to Culver.
Turnover starting to bounce out a little bit. Culver's a 10 now. Rochester's now crept up to 6.
Kruger back into the game. Schultz will come out. Foster comes back into the game. And Reinhold will come out.
He was trying to set up their press again. Need a little bit better rotations here. Try not to give up layups. Don't give up the easy one. Keep everyone in spots, but you got to go full speed, and you got to get to where you get on the pass, not wait till the catch.
Rochester, little havoc in the backcourt. Hansel picks up his dribble on the float-away pass. It's stolen by Abbott with 22. Cross-lane pass to Medina. Layup is good. Rochester up 27-26 with 17 seconds. Graham. For Culver, crosses the timeline with 11. Lob pass to Kruger with 9. Kruger in the right baseline with 7. He loses the handle, and then he fouls Medina. That's foul number 3 on Kruger. Taylor's going to go to the line to shoot one of the bonus with 5.5 seconds to play in the first half.
That's obviously huge because it's going to put you at the line, but then obviously your leading scorer and point guard and
a little frustration foul. He lost the handle. Medina grabbed it.
Medina's going to go to line. Chance to get double figures. He's got 9.
Liam Leininger back into the game for Rochester, and Thomas to come out. 5.5 seconds to play first half. Rochester up 27-26. And Taylor Medina at the line to shoot one and the bonus for the Zebras. Senior three dribbles, eyes it, flies it, no good. Rebound to Foster. Foster to Abbott for three, left wing, no good. And the rebound to Culver with two. And at the buzzer, the shot deflected, and we're at halftime. The Zebras lead 27-26. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda, 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Quarter we go here at Rochester High School. The Zebras up 27-26, and the Cavaliers will start the basketball. Now going to our left, Graham around the defense to Carnegie. Wrap around pass down low, taken away by Thomas. Actually, Thomas and what? Huh. Out of all the calls that could have happened there, I don't think the traveling was going to be on the top my first three guesses.
No. Quick score update and a biggie possibly. At the Tiger Den, or whatever they call that thing in Warsaw, Valley leads Warsaw 27-24 at half.
Yeah, that's a little surprising.
Head scratching.
Good call. Dog puts the free throw line. Back to Medina, and he travels. Great idea. He was going to a wide-open layup, and he got a little excited.
Turnovers in the first half. Culver had 12. Rochester had 7. They've each opened their first possession with turnovers. So,
30 seconds gone in the third. Rochester up by 1. 27-26, Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Rochester in that. You press again, forces a turnover, and Graham just commits a foul for Culver.
His second, team's first. Nice job by Dom anticipating the pass and just getting a deflection. A lot of those presses and traps, deflections are really what you want, because the deflections lead to, you don't have to steal passes yourself or, you know, steal dribbles. You want deflections and let teammates still get the ball. Nice job by Dom, and looks like he may have gotten Charlie.
Yeah,
force on the thigh.
Yeah.
Hopefully he can get that worked out quick and get back on the floor. That's a nice play.
Reinhold back into the game. Abbott runs the point. Left side to Holland behind the arc. Graham. Bounce pass to Medina in the left corner. No look pass to Reinhold. Top of the key. He drives it right. Come off at the elbow. Outside to Holland. Holland in the lane to Medina. Medina leans. Pass kicks it back outside to Abbott. And he'll reset for Rochester.
You mentioned about the fouls. Kruger is not on the floor at this point.
Yeah, good call. Dahlquist, left-handed layup, no good, but a foul coming on Schultz, and that's going to send Dahlquist to the line to shoot two.
Nice movement by the Zebras that time. Culver comes out in the zone, and they went to their kind of their basic wheel kind of play where they put four out, one in, get cutters through, and saw Noah flashing across the lane. Nice speed.
Good athletic move.
But it was a good move.
Yeah.
Good move to stay with it.
Dahlquist has two. First one on the way is short. He'll have one more.
Dahlquist has not scored yet tonight. He only started for the Zebras, who has not.
He hasn't been on the floor much.
Right, right. Hard to score when you're sitting in the chair.
That's right. Noah, second one on the way, and it's short again. And the rebound is tied up between Dahlquist and Villaquest. And the Rochester going to keep possession. Great hustle that time by Noah Dahlquist.
It was. You know, he's definitely going to be a player that's going to give you max effort all the time.
Yeah.
You don't have to worry about that from him.
Medina, baseline right. Minute gone in the third quarter. Rochester still at 27-26. Medina will trigger it in. Does so to Holland. Three on the right wing is short. And the rebound is Schultz. And now Graham will bring it up the floor.
Zebra's still going to try to trap even off a miss.
And Culver breaks his press. Graham has it between the rings against Abbott, the man-to-man defense. Schultz behind the arc, left wing in the corner to Villaquest. Look, a couple of dribbles for Culver. Baseline to Kresik. Kresik against Medina, drives left, throws up a shot, no good. And we're going to have a blocking foul on Rochester after the shot. Is that going to be on Medina?
No.
Oh.
15. Jordan Reinhold, where was that? I don't know where that was at. That was, and on the shot.
And on the shot. Medina was the one that was closest playing defense on him.
So Kresik will go to the line. The shoot two, first one on the way is good, and we're tied at 27. 6:32 to play third quarter, tied at 27. The Cavaliers will have one more free throw. Kresik will do that. Kresik with one more, looking to give the Cavs the lead again, and he does so.
Kresik has seven.
28-27 Cavaliers, Rochester the basketball. Holland runs the point through the center circle, works right wing to Abbott. Now to Dahlquist, quickly to Reinhold. He'll take the three. It's off the mark, no good. And the rebound to Holland right in front of Coach Reinhold. He accelerates into the lane. Leaner on the way is no good, but a foul coming on Graham. It's number three, and that's going to send Holland to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, so both of Culver's key guards now will have three fouls, and that's a huge impact. Credit to Zebras to keep attacking the basket against this man-to-man. Keep driving those lanes. Alex, you know, not just relying as a three-point shooter. He needs to create his offense elsewhere, and that's a good example of a drive and getting to the free throw line.
Holland's free throw is short. He'll have one more. What I liked about Holland's drive there is he was running, yes, towards the basket, and then about the free throw line, he accelerated the next gear, which helped him with that foul.
It's really effective to keep the defense off balance if you can get to multiple gears on your drive.
Second for Holland is in and out, no good. And Medina with the rebound. It kicks it out to Holland. It fakes the three. Now back to Abbott. Abbott holds between the circles. Left side to Medina. Looks at a three. Passes it up. Now to Holland in the left corner. Passes it to Abbott. Abbott feeds inside to Dahlquist. On the give and go, Abbott travels. Tough, tough, tough pass to handle at your feet.
Yeah, it was probably one that Noah probably should just maybe also hand it off as close as that cut was. It's tough to, he threw a bounce pass, which if he would have come at maybe the normal angle the play was designed, that's the right play, but he was coming in too close and probably should have just been a handoff.
Rochester in a trapping press. Law pass ahead to Villaquet, and then his pass is deflected out of bounds by Holland, and he came in from nowhere.
Yeah, that's what you need. Yeah, and that trap, that's what you need. Those guards have to, when the ball goes to the corner, those guards from the top have got to sprint down. That's what makes that effective. Just get the ball out of bounds and allow yourself to reset the defense versus giving up a layup.
28-27 Culver. Graham lobs it in to Carnegie. Carnegie drives it right at the free throw line. Now back to back out behind the three-point line between the rings out of Graham. Graham drives against Holland. Cut off at the elbow to Carnegie. Carnegie, a couple of dribbles to him. And out of Schultz, stands between the rings against Dahlquist. Easy, young man, he's playing the three already. Graham drives it against Holland at the free throw line. To Carnegie, fakes the three-pointer, drives it inside the three-point line. Now out to Graham, and Culver will reset. Good defense by Rochester.
Yeah, just keeping guys in front of him and making Culver pass around the perimeter. This is where you see with Everett Kruger not on the floor, not too much leadership there for Cavs.
And Graham just picked up foul number four on the charge. Great job by Brett Abbott, who set up for the charge and got it. And that's going to send Coach Kruger to the bench, and he'll bring in Weston Bush for Graham, and now both guards for the Cavs in foul trouble.
Heady play by Abbott. You know, to get a charge, you got to be thinking ahead of time. You can't get a charge if you're going to react to somebody. He had good defensive position, saw that drive the whole way, and got in good position.
5:15 to play in the third. Culver up 28-27. Rochester basketball going to our right. Holland runs the point. Now to Foster High on the left side and the baseline to Thomas. Dom studies against the man-to-man defense. Cross court to Holland. Fakes a three. Drives it just inside the arc. Pull up. Jumper's good, and Rochester back up. 29-28.
Excellent use of the shot fake. You know they're going to come after you as a three-point shooter. Use that to your advantage. A little shot fake created a much more open 18-footer.
Shot fake. You listening? Bush has the basketball. Top of the key. Got a Kresik. Kresik out to Bush, high on the right side. Man-to-man defense by the Zebras with 4:35 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 29-28. Carnegie, cross-court pass to Bush. Bush drives against Holland. Baseline to Villaquet, and he is fouled by Taylor Medina. And Villaquet will go back to the line to shoot two.
It's going to be Medina's third.
Liam Leininger will come back in out of the first free throw. And also coming in for the first time tonight is Josh Robbins. Make that John Robbins, a 6'2 senior for the Cavs. Villaquette has two with 4:29 to play in the third. First one on the way is no good. Too hard. He'll have one more. So Leininger's in, Foster's out, Robbins in, and Schultz will sit. Actually, Taylor Medina comes out.
Yeah, coming out with three fouls. Definitely don't want to risk that at this point. You got some more bodies you guys can rotate in there. Don't have to risk it at this point.
Second one for Villaquette rattles in, and we're tied at 29.
Villaquette has 11 now, leads Kev from scoring.
4:25 to play third quarter. Rochester the basketball. Holland drives it left to the left hand to Abbott, to Leininger, right side to Foster. Foster drives in the paint, jumps top, rises up, and calls for travel.
Just because it looks awkward doesn't always mean it's travel. I mean, it's that jump, stop, hop, you know. He leaves his both feet at the same time. He's good.
Pass goes ahead, and Culver saves him going out of bounds, but right into the hands of Thomas. Down across the timeline left, drives it all the way to the basket, throws up a shot, no good. The rebound put back by Foster's good!
First bench points for the Zebras.
And now we're going to have a double team. Oh, we're going to have a foul on Rochester. I thought they forced Bush into a double dribble.
Foul's going to be on Leininger. Only his first, team third.
4 minutes of play in the third quarter. Rochester up 31-29. I think his biggest lead of the night has been, five or six by Rochester?
They had it at eight at one point early.
Yeah, you're right.
Something like 18-10, something like that.
So Culver will look to inbounds right in front of the Rochester bench. Villaquette's pass is kicked out of bounds by Abbott. We'll try it again.
Pretty athletic group here for the Zebras on the floor. You got Don Thomas as your post player, but Foster, Abbott, Leininger, and Holland.
Villaquette will try it again. Around Abbott. Bounce pass in. This time to Bush. Bush pass at the hands of Lafitte of Carnegie. Carnegie gets it back. Set of Robbins. Robbins loses it, and we're going to have a reach-in foul on Abbott. It'll be out of bounds to Culver underneath their own basket, baseline left.
Call that ball on Foster, his second.
Huh? Ball forward. Okay.
Well.
All right.
The whistles have taken over.
Well, they both have a four on their jersey, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. I think Coach would probably trade that, all right, at this point.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, Brett has not committed a foul.
The inbound pass is kicked away. Culver going to try it again. 3:48 to play in the third, Rochester by two. Bush looks to get it in around Holland. Bush directs traffic. Bounce pass in the corner to Robbins. Now to Kresick. Kresick takes Dominic Thomas to the block. Against a double team, throws up a shot. It's no good, and we're going to have a foul on Rochester. And Kresick will go back to the line to shoot two.
If this pace continues, both coaches might want to drop to the JV and tell them to get some uniforms on. Foster's third. Team's fifth. And Krizik will go line. He's got seven, 3 for 4 from the line so far.
Krizik's free throw is no good. He'll have one more. Rochester by two with 3:41 to play in the third quarter. And here comes Kruger after a five-minute hiatus. Schultz coming back in.
This will be the 10th free throw of the quarter between both teams. There's only been two made shots in this quarter, one by Holland and one by Foster. Everything else been from the free throw line.
Kresick's second one in and out, no good. And Leininger hasn't knocked out of bounds, but they're going to say last touch by Schultz. Zebra's going to keep possession. Quickly up the floor is Holland. Runs the point as Alex. Works to the right side to Foster. Foster to Leininger, top of the key. Liam drives. Dump pass down low to Foster, and we're going to have a three-second call on Brett Abbott. You just don't see that a whole lot anymore.
No, it seems, especially once you're making an offensive move, you sometimes get the benefit of the doubt. If somebody's making a move to the basket, they kind of, you know, if there's no play and you're just kind of hanging out, they might call it. But usually when a guy's making a move, they tend to let that go.
Carnegie gets it in to Kruger. Kruger tiptoes the sideline, gets it to Carnegie, back door to Villaquette, and has it, and Foster knocked it off the leg of Villaquette out of bounds, and Rochester going to get it back after another turnover.
Just enough to get a deflection and then off of the Culver's leg, which was great because it almost threaded the needle for a layup.
Abbott runs a point through the center circle. 3:15 to play. Third quarter. Rochester up 31-29. And that scoring frenzy in the first half has come to a screeching halt. Foster drives it. Outside of Wilson Lee, travels.
That's the Zebras' fifth turnover of this quarter. Culver has three turnovers this quarter, and the Zebras have scored 4 points this quarter, and Culver has scored three, and we played 5 minutes. Hopefully I can make it for Thanksgiving dinner. Game has come screeching to a halt.
You're more than welcome to come to ours. And I'm disappointed we're not having duck for you. Kruger over the top of the defense to Schultz. 18-footer over Dom Thomas. No good. Weak side rebound to Carnegie. Carnegie for the Cavaliers puts it up. No good. And Schultz comes over the back of Wilson Lee. He's going to commit a foul. Rochester going to have the basketball. 2:46 to play in the third.
Fouls on Schultz. That's his third. Culver's fifth.
31-29. Rochester on top. Again, 2:45 to play in the third quarter. Tony Stasiak on David Musselman. Holland runs the point. High on the left side to Thomas. Dom to Abbott. Abbott drives it right. Stop. Pop. And before the shot, we're going to have a travel. And as that's what you said.
Yep.
If you're going to do that little bunny hop, you got to go up with 2 feet, land with 2 feet, and that time Brett didn't.
Yep. I'm not sure that one was. I mean, that's anticipating. Sometimes I think when it looks awkward, referees tend to call that. Another turnover.
Another traveling on Culver. Rochester going to get back on that far sideline. 2:28 to play in the third. Rochester by two. Getting more scores?
Yes, at halftime, Manchester leads Mississinawa 29-17. Columbia City 24, Wichita 6. All at the half.
Abbott gets away with the travel. His leaner's good. Rochester up by four now, 33-29. Full-court press by the Zebras. Villaquette crosses the timeline, has it knocked out of bounds by Holland. It'll stay on the far side of the Cavs. Manchester's going to be good. Holy cow, they're going to be good.
Yeah. Right.
Holland just about steals the inbounds pass. Kruger takes it left. Jump pass out of bounds. Dad looks at son, shakes his head a little bit. I've seen that look.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
He just had a look. The kid got lucky. He just had a look. Sometimes I don't think my kid gets that lucky.
Sometimes that's worse than saying anything.
True.
Pat Thomas, turnaround jumper in the block. Is no good off the mark. Carnegie skies to the board and grabs it. Now to head to Kruger. Kruger picks his way through traffic, and Rochester is going to pick up a cheap foul with 1:44 to play in the third, up by four.
That foul is going to be on Wilson Lee. Only his first, but team six. That's the danger zone. Culver's going to shoot free throws the rest of the half, and there's 1:44 left in the third. So Zebras got to be smart about the fouls. You don't want to give away points by committing silly fouls like that where you had two guys on the ball and just a reach you didn't need.
Kruger against Abbott. Abbott ahead to Carnegie. I'll make that to Kruger ahead to Carnegie. Carnegie jump stop, feeds down low to Kresik. Jumper over Thomas is good.
When they've been able to get the ball to him down low, he's been a solid post presence.
Well, especially that deep. Thomas in the lane. Folder's good. Dom Thomas with two more, and it's 35-31.
Tom's got four.
Full court press. Pass stocked away. Abbott has it. Rises up. Reverse layup is good. 37-31. 1:10 to play in the first half. Dom Thomas set that one up. And Kruger knocks it off the leg of Brett Abbott out of bounds. And now we're going to have a Culver timeout. It will be a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 1:07 to play in the third quarter. Rochester's lead now is 6 at 37-31.
Nice little spurt by the Zebras. Got some defensive intensity there. Got some deflections. Don Thomas with some heads-up plays, making the extra pass for layups. Spurt, you know, it's only a 6-point lead, but the way that quarter was kind of going back and forth, that's a nice spurt there to give you some room here heading hopefully into the fourth
yeah.
quarter. Quick score here,
yep.
Lewis Cass 54, North Miami 16, end of the third. And also at the end of the third, Logansport 57, Peru 44.
That'll be a good one coming down to the end. Kruger breaks the press himself, down low to a wide open Villaquette. His leaner off the glass is good.
Good fundamental move up and over.
Yeah. Holland quickly on the other way for Rochester and carries the basketball. Another turnover on Rochester. Lead is 4 now, 50 seconds to play in the third. Carnegie will trigger it in right in front of the Rochester bench. Carnegie around Medina. Bounce pass comes into Kruger. Kruger's had a clean third quarter, no fouls. Abbott rides him all the way up the court. Kruger fakes the pass going left, now goes back to the right. Kresick feeds down to Villaquette, and we're going to have a foul coming on Holland. Is that going to be right?
Huh. If that is on Holland, it'll be his second. You know, one of the things, I don't have a shot chart here, but if we looked at Culver's shot chart, it's just inside 5 feet. I don't
yeah.
think they've knocked down an outside
yeah.
perimeter shot. It's been layups, post moves, and free throws. If the Zebras can kind of take that away, maybe dare them to knock down some outside shots. I know you're pressuring them. That's where some of the layups, but in the half court, really, I think the Zebras heading in the fourth is going to have to do a nice job of maybe sealing off that the post play for Culver.
Quit at the line. First one of the way is good. He'll have one more. Dom make that stop. Dahlquist comes back in, and Thomas will come out. You know, one thing I've noticed about the post play for Culver, when they do get a pass in the paint, they are deep.
Yeah.
It's tough to stop that.
Good post position and also good post feed. That's part of it. You get good post position, you want those guards to make a nice pass to make your job easier, and Culver guards have done a good job there, too.
Look what second one off the mark, no good. Offensive rebound. Kresick in the lane against the triple team, throws up a shot. It's good. 37-36, Rochester with 25 seconds to play, third quarter. Reinhold back to Holland, to Abbott high on the right side, to Dahlquist, ball loose, Abbott picks it up, middle of the floor for Rochester, drives it right, stop, down low to Dahlquist in the paint, jumper on the way is too hard, fights for the rebound, gets it back with 10, outside to Holland for three, it's in and out, no good, rebound to Carnegie with five, down to Everett to Kresick with two, to Bush with Schultz with three at the buzzer, no good. After three, Rochester leads 37-36. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save. Buying your first home? Let the experts at First Federal Savings Bank help you through the process. At First Federal, all of their mortgage loans are serviced locally, with payment options that are convenient for you. Their staff will work with you, answering your questions and providing professional service. First Federal will even pay standard closing costs for qualifying first-time homebuyers. Just another way First Federal takes care of you, your local mortgage lender.
To the fourth quarter we go here at Rochester High School. The Zebras leading 37-36. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. The Cavaliers will start the fourth and final quarter of the basketball.
Leading scorers, Valaquette has 14 for Culver, Kissick has 11, and Alec Holland has 16 for the Zebras.
Well, the problem with Holland was 16. He only had two in that quarter. And then Holland steals the pass. Holland will go in for the right-handed layup. He now has 18 points and a three-point lead for the Zebras. Graham quickly up the floor for the Cavaliers. Works to the wing. Cut off by the defense. Down the paint. Right side of the floor. Throws in a prayer. No good. Dawkins on the board. Gives to Holland. Holland runs. Left side of the floor. Holland stops. Pop. No good. Rebound to Lee. His putback is good. 41-36.
Lee's first point.
Rochester by five with 7:15 to play in the game. Carnegie against Medina. Works it left. Behind his back dribble. Middle of the floor. Picks up the ball. Now Graham near the timeline. Graham right side of Illiquette. Illiquette against Wilson Lee. Top to Graham. Graham against Holland. He backs it out and resets for the Cavaliers. Now to Kruger. Kruger looking. Drives it right. Cut off on the defense. Still keeps his dribble. Now in the middle of the floor. And we're going to have a foul on the Rochester Zebras.
Nope.
We're going to have a foul on Gressick.
Yep. Only his first. Call for six. So the Zebras will shoot free throws. Both teams will be shooting free throws the rest of the way. Surprising. That got pretty physical in the post for what they called in the third quarter.
Yeah.
I thought for sure there was a foul coming in the post, and they ended up on the legal screen out front.
Cash Harris in the game for the first time tonight. Yeah, I didn't see the one either. I did see three.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's big because that's on three. Graham's done.
Yeah.
So they wanted to make sure they got that right.
So Rochester gets it back after the turnover.
Although I did see a game this week where you could foul out with four fouls.
Do tell.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. We're going to foul down low on Schultz. And I think that was last week.
Yeah, it was Friday. Foul was on 50. Jason Schultz is fourth.
They whistled that against Alexa Holland, by the way.
Yeah, somehow.
And Keaton got tagged.
Another official changed the number and got reported, and the very next play would have it. That was a foul, and yeah.
Dahlquist free throw, no good. Carnegie skies to the board and grabs it. Carnegie then is fouled by Dahlquist, and that will send Carnegie to the line to shoot one and the bonus for the Cavaliers.
They're going to say the foul's on Wilson Lee. His second.
I'm just
going to
guess because
that would be Dahlquist's fourth.
Yeah. 6:39 to play in the game. Rochester by five. Carnegie at the line to shoot one the bonus for the Cavaliers.
Carnegie's got 3 points. He's 1 for 2 from the line so far.
Carnegie one in the bonus. Three dribbles. Right-handed free throw on the way. Good. One more. Carnegie is a sophomore. Good-looking player for the Cavaliers.
Yeah. You can tell he's kind of got that nerves, maybe first varsity game. There's some athleticism. There's some talent there. He's just not quite sure when to go and when to hold back.
Free throw no good. Holland with the rebound and runs for Rochester. Holland middle of the floor, underhand pass to Lee. Back to Holland. Then to Medina for three, left wing. In and out, no good. Rebound to fall four. Cashins out of there with it. Now to Kruger, picks up a loose ball. Now right side to Carnegie. Carnegie drives to the baseline, cut off by the defense. Now to Kruger. Kruger around Abbott, pull-up jumper from 18 feet is good. That's a good-looking shot by Everett Kruger.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the first kind of perimeter shot the Cavs have hit. It's been all inside and free throws.
Medina to Abbott, 41-39. Rochester, six to play in the game. Holland in the corner to Dahlquist. Shoot it. Outside to Abbott. Quickly left side to Medina in the corner to Holland. Holland three over the cash. Harris, no good. And the outlet pass is knocked out of bounds by Holland. It will stay with Culver with 5:49 to play in the game.
Sure, point of emphasis for Coach Kruger at halftime for Culver and as well as third quarter is cut off the Rochester offensive board.
Yeah.
That's allowed Rochester to score some easy buckets, and Culver's done a better job here than those last few minutes.
Gressick against Wilson Lee, takes him to the lane, kicks it outside to Carnegie, 15-footers in and out, no good. Kruger with the rebound and put back is good, and we're tied at 41.
Kruger has eight.
5.5 to play in the game. Abbott backs his way in, throws a shot up on the baseline, no good. Gressick with the rebound, gives to Everett Kruger. Kruger against Abbott, ooh, gets him right in the chin with the elbow, crosses the timeline against Holland. Holland almost picks his pocket, goes out of bounds. It'll stay with Culver on the far side.
maybe some quick offense maybe for Coach, so quicker looks down there. You know, it's one thing if you're knocking down some shots, getting quick offense, but I think Coach kind of wanted them to slow down a little bit and work the offense as you're getting into crunch time in a tie game.
5:17 to play in the game. We're tied at 41. Culver the basketball. Carnegie, got to get it in. Got to get it in. Does so over Dom Thomas to Kresik. And Kruger loses it. Oh, we're going to have a foul on Rochester. I don't know what Kruger was doing. He tried to stay on his side of the 10-second line, which he could have come across and got the basketball. And then Rochester bailed him out with a foul, and Kruger going to go to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
Abbott's first, ninth on the Zebras.
Foster back in. Dahlquist to come out. Villaquet will come back in as well. And Villaquet will replace Schultz for the Cavaliers.
The Valley score has turned around a little bit. End of the third quarter, Warsaw 47, Valley 34.
Yeah.
Maybe a little bit of a speech by Coach Ogle for the Tigers at halftime.
41-41. 5:12 to play in the game. Kruger's free throw is good. And Culver leads now 42-41.
Kruger has 5 points here in about the last minute and a half of game action.
One more coming for the junior. Kruger's second one, good again.
And just like that, he enters double figures with 10.
43-41. Culver with 5:10 to play in the ball game. And Coach Reinhold will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the game. The Cavaliers lead 43-41, and after the Rochester timeout, they'll have the basketball going to our right. Cody Stasiak, I'm David Musselman.
In terms of timeout situations, Culver has a 30 and 2 fulls left, and Rochester has a 30 and 3 fulls left. Full team shooting free throws the rest of the way.
And if it stays this tight, I'm guessing we'll end up with zero by the end. Medina gets it into Thomas. Outside to Abbott at the volleyball line, right in front of the Rochester bench. 5 minutes to play in the game. Rochester down by two. Abbott's going to do something with the basketball. He's going to get a 5-second count. And there it is.
Yep. Closely guarded. You got to get somewhere on that dribble. Not a lot of movement. Didn't really get anywhere. And that leads to a turnover.
Full court press by the Zebras. Carnegie gets it in to Kruger. Back to Carnegie. Carnegie to Kruger behind the arc and left wing. Kruger just about had the ball stolen from him. Regains the dribble. Goes left side to baseline. Hands off to Carnegie. Runs around the defense. And then his pass is tipped away and stolen by Holland. Holland will go in for the right-handed layup. It's good, and we're tied at 43. 4.5 to play in the game. Culver basketball. Four-court press. Harris to head to Carnegie. Carnegie back to Harris and travels. Reinhold comes back into the game and Foster to come out.
I have that at turnover number 19 for the Cavs.
Graham comes back in for Culver and Carnegie will come out.
Zebras have 15 turnovers.
4:26 to play in the game. We're tied at 43 here at Rochester High School. The Zebras will have the basketball. Holland through the center circle against Harris. You might want to exploit that matchup maybe a little. Bounce pass to Thomas, right side to Abbott, down low to Reinhold. Reinhold to the right baseline, outside to Abbott. Reinhold.
Dom Thomas being guarded by Kruger.
I didn't even see that.
Yeah. They've worked that game in the post a little bit. Mismatching size, plus they're, you know, he got somebody in foul trouble there. But Abbott's going to go to the free throw line.
Yep, foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two. We're tied at 43 with 4:09 to play in the game.
Kruger just picked up his fourth foul anyways on the reach in and help. Like I said, sometimes you might be guarding somebody who's not a threat offensively, but you get your hand caught in the cookie jar and you pick up a cheap foul there.
Free throw by Abbott is good. Rochester up 44-43.
Abbott, 8 points.
Rochester with a couple in doubles.
Not yet. Medina's been at 9 since half, and now Abbott's at 9, and then Holly's got 20.
45-43, Rochester. Graham through the center circle against the defense, outside to Kresik. Splits the pass, down low, taken away by Holland. Rochester runs, up by two. Holland, middle of the floor, stop, three-pointer on the way, no good. Holland will make that right hole with the rebound. Medina, down low to right hole. To Thomas, jumper in the lane is good, and Rochester up by four, 47-43. Boy, that'll brought the crowd to the feet if Holland knocks down that three. Quickly up by four is Culver. To Harris, three from the left wings, in and out, no good. Rebound to Abbott. And then Reinhold and Kresik tied up. Rochester going to get it back. We're going to have a foul. A foul on Culver. And now we're going to have a technical on Kruger, and he is done.
Yep, that'll be his fifth. The guy farthest away from the play makes the call. Looks like the foul.
The foul is going to
on 33, Kresik, which would be his third. Team's ninth.
Kruger picks up the tee.
In the aftermath, Kruger picks up the technical, which means he's done with his fifth foul, and then that becomes the team's tenth.
So this is what I think happened. Kruger is frustrated with the called foul, chucks the basketball over the official's head, standing on the baseline, and that's what warranted the technical, according to the referee. So Kruger is done. And one of the bonus coming, plus two more.
Right. So you have your foul shot on the common foul, which will be free throws there, and then you'll have your technical free throws, and the Zebras get the ball out of bounds. So if you can make some free throws and possession, you can give yourself a significant cushion, at least for the way this game's gone, to that.
And so that was Culver's 10th team foul, so it'll be four free throws coming for Rochester with 3.5 to play in the game. The Zebras leading by four, 47-43. Now the officials meeting with both head coaches at midcourt and talking things over. It hasn't been ugly, I don't think.
No, it's not been physical. I think the players maybe are frustrated with the way it's been called. The players aren't getting overly physical with each other. It's not been that kind of game, but I think some of that is what's been called sometimes down the floor and what's not been called. And in that case, the two guys who are each within about 5 feet of the play didn't call anything, and the guy who's out at half court, farthest from the play, made the call. And I think that's been the frustrating part probably for both coaches and both teams.
So Holland at the line, will he take all four? Holland's free throw for the Tech is good as it rattles in. He'll have one more. So Carnegie and Schultz back in. Kruger, who is done, comes out. Holland makes both free throws.
He's got 22.
And he'll take two more. Holland's second one on the way. Good again. Or a third one, I should say. He'll have one more. Fourth one. No good.
Struck at 23 temporarily, but if they run the offense that Coach probably wants and spread it out a little bit, I'm sure the ball will be in his hands and Culver will have to trap or foul and more opportunities to shoot free throws.
50-43, Rochester leads with 3.5 minutes to play in the game. And Culver's main ball handler and scorer has just fouled out. Holland to Thomas, high on the left side. To Abbott. Abbott drives it, stops, rises up, shot on the way, no good. Carnegie the rebound. Carnegie with the basketball. The sophomore picking his way through traffic, almost has it stolen. Ball still loose. Culver has it. Graham now to Schultz. Schultz goes to the basket hard and is going to be called for a foul on the shot by Thomas. And that's going to send Schultz to the line to shoot two. Boy, well, the way he took off from the wing, he was going to the basket. I thought he was going to run over Thomas.
There's no doubt where he was going. Dom was almost there in time. Just a little bit, half step slow, I think, in getting legal guarding position.
3:06 to play in the game. Rochester up by seven.
Schultz has not scored nor been to the free throw line yet at this point.
Tristan Schultz, a 6'3 junior, left-handed free throw, no good. He'll have one more.
brother of Tatum Schultz.
Yeah, perhaps? I was going to say, we're going to see his sister here in a couple of days. Second one by the big man. Good this time. 50-44. Rochester by 6, 3 to play in the game. Abbott, jump stop, high on the left side, backs it out against the man-to-man defense. We'll reset top of the key now to Holland.
6-point lead, under 3 minutes to go, I think. You work your offense, try to get layups, you get really, really good shots. Move the ball, time's on your side as long as you have possession.
Thomas, turnaround jumpers on the way, in and out, no good. Carnegie with another big board. Carnegie gives the head to Harris. Harris now to Villaquette, he travels.
Yep. You know, Zebras moved the ball a little bit, but that was maybe a contested shot. Dom taking a turnaround contested jumper may not be the look you want at that point. But again, this is the first game of the year. You're kind of working out those kinks. That delay game may not have been something that you spend a lot of time on as you're trying to get out all your basic stuff in.
Holland, jumper from the free throw line, too long. And Medina skies to the board, but comes over the back of Schultz, and that's going to send Schultz back to the line to shoot two free throws for the Cavaliers.
And before Medina. So why that's a double, you know, another kind of quick contested look, and then you foul, and you're going to allow Culver to go to the line to score when the clock's not running, which when you're in the lead, you'd like to stay away from that.
2:27 to play in the game. Rochester up 50-44. And Tristan Schultz back at the line to shoot two freebies for the Cavaliers, and Rochester will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the game. Rochester by 6. After the timeout for Rochester, Schultz will be at the free throw line to shoot 2.
Like final, Lewis Cass 73, North Miami 32. John Glenn beats Southland Clay 65-38. Triton leads Oregon Davis 47-32, end of the third.
Free throw for Schultz is good. One more.
Again, thanks to Val for keeping us updated as the night goes on.
Schultz with one more, looking to cut this lead to 4. Second one for the big man is no good. And the rebound to Carnegie. Outside to Harris. His pass tipped away and stolen by Abbott. Abbott, right side of the floor, coast to coast. Right-handed layup is short. The rebound to Reinhold, who dribbles out of it. Now to Medina, who holds it with 2:15 to play in the game. Rochester by 5. Reinhold, top of the key. Works left side. And now we're going to have a delayed carry call. Rochester going to give it back to Culver.
Culver's coach made a good call on that one.
Yeah, that's what I thought too. Robbins back into the game and Schultz to sit down. 2:06 to play in the game, Rochester by 5. Carnegie right in front of the Rochester bench will look to trigger it in. Just to Graham. Graham playing with 4 personal fouls to Harris. Harris ahead to Villaquette. Villaquette against the double team to Harris. Ball loose. Ball still loose, so we're going to have a foul coming on Thomas. That's going to send Harris to the line to shoot 2.
Well, foul's going to be on Ryan. On 11, Dom's 4th. Culver in double bonus. And Harris will be at the line, has not scored nor been to the line yet. He was up 5 with 1:55 left.
Harris free throw, no good. 1:55 to play in the game. I think both teams down to 3 timeouts, yes?
Yes.
Harris with 1 more. Isaac flies it, no, off the glass. With an offensive rebound to Villaquette. He puts it up, he's fouled on the shot. Who will it be on?
Sundom, it's his 5th.
He hangs his head like it will be on him. Nope, but it'll be on Brett Abbott. And Villaquette will go to the line to shoot 2.
Brett 2nd.
A 1:52 to play in the game. Rochester by 5.
But again, self-inflicted wound, especially with the new rule this year where you can leave on the release, not on the rim. That puts a big emphasis all game long, but especially in these situations, where you can enter the lane on the release. You got to get back to fundamental blockout, which I like the rule because it's not just a random gamble, but you got to work on your technique. You got to get that blockout taken care of, and you get that rebound, then they're probably going to foul you. But instead, you give them an opportunity to score with the clock stop.
Villaquette makes one of two. Dahlquist skies the board. Holland has it now at a minute 45. 50-46, Rochester on top, a minute 45 to play in the basketball game. Reinholt back to Abbott, right on the timeline. Dribbles around the defense. Goes to the basket, fouled the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Thought he could get that one to go.
Yep, it's off the point. You know, you got to kind of contest it. You kick out, keep the clock moving. But get to the free throw line and then make sure you take advantage of that.
Abbott at the line to shoot two. A minute 37 to play in the game. Rochester up 50-46. Abbott, right-handed free throw shooter, eyes it, flies it, good. And he'll have one more. Leininger back into the game. Dahlquist will come out. Schultz back in for Culver.
Brett just joined the double figures club with 10 points.
Abbott with one more, looking to push this lead to six. Abbott, second one on the way. Good again. 52-46. Rochester on top. A minute 30 to play in the game. Carnegie ahead to Schultz. Schultz against Leininger. Gives ahead to Medina. Yeah, Medina steals the basketball. Right side of the floor for Rochester. A minute 25 to play in the game. Rochester does not need to shoot again. Abbott against Graham. Abbott can keep it. Graham's not going to foul out. Reinholt to Medina. Medina then fouled by Carnegie. That's going to send Taylor to the line to shoot two for the Zebras, who lead by six with a minute 14 to play in the game.
Carnegie's first. Medina going to line. Well, he's been stuck on 9 points since halftime. So if he can make this, he'll be the third Zebra in double figures, joining Holland with 23 and Abbott with 11.
Taylor Medina at the line to shoot two for the Zebras. Rochester up 52-46. A minute 14 to play in the game. Medina's free throw is good.
And there's our third Zebra in double figures. That's a good sign.
One more coming for the senior.
Logan Sport beat Peru 79-58.
Wow.
Columbia City beats Witco 73-16.
Wow. Second one by Medina is good. 8-point lead for the Zebras. A minute 13 to play in the game. And then the pass from Schultz is taken away by Holland. A minute 8 to play in the game. Rochester by 8 to Medina. High on the right side. Medina, almost travels, yep. From now to Abbott.
From what they'd called earlier, surprised they didn't.
And Leininger is fouled on his way to the basket. He'll go to the line to shoot two. It's 57.5 to play in the game.
You know, you got to talk about that last play down the other, and great hustle play by Alec Holland. Looked like he was going to be open layup. Schultz turns, throws a bounce pass. Holland comes out of nowhere. That's a great effort play.
So 57.5 to play in the game. Liam Leininger at the line to shoot two for the Zebras, looking to push this to a 10-point lead. Biggest lead of the night has been 9.
Leininger has not scored nor been to the line. Zebras have 4 points off the bench, 2 apiece for Lee and Foster.
not off the bank for tonight.
On that one.
I don't know what Rex is doing. He just took off his tie. I mean, there's only less than a minute to play.
Good volume of free throws for both teams, but coaches probably talk about the makes, makes they'd like to have, but it is the first game.
Leininger, second one. Freshman eyes it, flies it, looks better, it is better. Rochester matches their biggest lead of the night of 9, 55-46, 57 to play in the game. Graham ahead to Harris, and he is fouled by Reinholt.
Kind of in the spot where you want, Jordan's fourth. Idea was okay. He was going to be there. Maybe thought about taking a charge, but that's the same thing, too. Keep the clock running. Just keep him in front. And still one fourth clock stop.
Dahlquist will come in after the first free throw. Robbins also will come in. Cash Harris at the line to shoot two for the Cavs. First one for the youngsters. Good. 55-47 Rochester. 53 seconds to play in the game. Dahlquist is in, and Leininger will come out.
Big thing for the Zebras now is to inbound the ball. It's obviously the highest priority. Get the ball inbound. Get it to your free throw shooters. Make your free throws and don't give up rebounds. You're off missed free throws.
Harris, the second one, no good. Long rebound comes down to Abbott. 50 seconds. Rochester going to take all 10 seconds to get that across the timeline. Abbott across the timeline against Villaquette. at the elbow, outside to Medina, back to Abbott, who backs it out near the volleyball line with 40. Rochester up 55-47. Medina has it at the elbow, kicks it out to Abbott at the between the circles, now to Holland with 30. Holland drives it with 29. Wrap around pass to Reinholdt. Three on the way, right way. He's good. Rochester by 11 with 20 seconds of play in the game. Don't you know we'll be talking to Coach Reinholdt about that shot with less than 30 to play in the game.
Oh, no. Oh, great shot. First varsity point for Mr. Reinholdt. First of many, I'm sure, but that was a nice three, nice moment.
19 seconds to play in the game, Rochester by 11.
Don't want a foul here. Play good defense, stop fouling, take care of the boards, and clean this game up and go home with a win.
Carnegie has his inbound pass stolen by Holland with 15. Holland then travels, or makes that to carries it. And it's going to go back to Culver. 15 seconds to play. Rochester going to open their season at 1-0. 58-47, Rochester by 11 with 15 seconds to play in the game. Foster will come back into the game. And Alec Holland, who had a tremendous first game of the season, comes out.
Yes, well-deserved ovation there. Ends up with 23. Just did a nice job. Good four game, good hustle.
Harris with 10. To Robbins with 9. Back to Harris. Drives it in the paint. Throws up a shot over Reinholdt. Good in the foul. And Jordan has just fouled out.
Yep. Memorable moment there. Foul your first game. Hey, did better than Courtney Felke. Courtney Felke's first game as a freshman, she fouled out and did not score. He fouled out, but at least he got a three to drop. So if they can have similar career paths, I think he'll take it.
So Wilson Lee will come back into the game, and Jordan is done. 58-49, 7 seconds to play in the game. Culver at the free throw line. Again, Rochester up by 9. And Harris at the free throw for 1. It is on the way and no good. Rebound to Thomas. Nice rebound by Dom. With 3. Ahead to Foster with 1, and that'll do it. Rochester wins their opener tonight, 58-49. Post-game show coming up next on 92.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account, learn more about our online banking options, or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
I've been buying vehicles at Shepherd Chevrolet for over 16 years. They've always had the vehicle I wanted at a price that I could afford. I trust Shepherd's sales staff to give me the best price and the best financing available. From my work trucks to my personal vehicle, Shepherd's is the only choice for me. Stop out to Shepherd Chevrolet today to get your next vehicle. They really are my local hometown Chevy dealer.